you believe it's already Christmas time? I can't. There's so much to do. There's presents to wrap. There's gifts to give. There's trees to decorate. There's cookies to decorate. I just can't get it all done.
Hold on, lovey. Presents and cookies and trees, they're all great, but we can't forget the real meaning of Christmas. Santa Claus!
Hold on there, Skipper Jay. I think we're both forgetting the real meaning of Christmas. I mean, Santa is fun and all, but did you know that Santa was a Christian named Saint Nicholas? And he would give money and presents to the poor. He lived a very humble Christian life. So we have to remember the real meaning of Christmas. It isn't Saint Nicholas or Santa Claus. It's Jesus.
That's right. We celebrate the birth of Jesus on Christmas. Thanks for reminding me, lovey. You know, it can be so easy to forget about Jesus when we have so much going on, so much shopping and Christmas fun and stuff.
All the more reason we need to remember why Jesus was even born in the first place. And bet all the friends are excited to remember along with us.
Yes, let's go learn how to honor Jesus on Christmas.
We'll be right back.
We are keys for kiddos.
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 Get when you cross a snowman and a vampire. Frostbite!
Well, Merry Christmas, kiddos! Merry Christmas, Bosworth!
Merry Christmas, Mr. Phil! Merry Christmas, Bosworth!
And you, Ted, greetings to you all as well! Ca 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 ca!
Ca ca ca!
Ca ca ca!
Ca ca ca!
Ca ca ca! Well, that sounded great. So Yuletide greetings, huh, Bosworth? Yes, do you even know what that means? Of course I do. You give me $10, you gonna tie the other 10 this week. Well, Bosworth, what have you been up to? Oh, I had been there dizzy. Thank you very much. Well, what have you been doing, Bosworth? Lee? You see this here sack?
I do. What's it for?
Well, everybody goes on this chance a year that the Christmas spirit, how they all got it, this and wants it and that and can't get enough of it. So I figured I'd catch it in this here sack and sell it to them.
I don't really think you'll be successful in catching the Christmas spirit in your sack.
Oh, I won't, huh?
No, I just don't think that you will.
Well, sir. Okay, can I borrow your tool set?
What do you need tools for, Bosworth?
Yeah, what do you need tools for?
Well, so as I can build me your trap.
Why do you need a trap for, Bosworth?
Well, just so I can catch me that Christmas spirit and put it in this here sack.
Bosworth, you really can't catch Christmas spirit in a trap. You can't put it in a sack.
Oh, I can't, huh?
No, you can't.
Ca 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 ca! Come here, little fella. Ca 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 ca!
What are you doing?
Well, sir, you said I couldn't catch it in the sack. I couldn't catch it in the trap. So I thought if I was really nice to it, I could get it to come to me and then zip, catch it right up and put it in this here sack.
Oh, boy.
Did it come to you?
Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, really? What exactly is the Christmas spirit?
Well, Bosworth, Christmas spirit is more like a mood.
Oh,
on! Oh, that's funny. That's funny. You don't say. Does it give milk? No.
Not a cow. A mood. A giving mood.
Oh, yes, Bosworth. You see, Christmas Day is the day when we celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And the Christmas spirit is the manifestation of the tidings of great joy, which are for all men, that the angels brought down to us from heaven.
Oh, no. Well, that is some good news. That news is worth crowing about. Y'all kids ready?
Ready, Bosworth.
Well, here we go. Caw-caw-caw!
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 Caw-caw-caw! Well, kiddos, I think it's time for us to say goodbye for now. No, it's not. What? We have not yet done the Christmas carol.
We haven't rehearsed the song. Well, that's all right. You ain't gonna sing it. Bosworth, I'm a ventriloquist.
Oh, that's distressing. What? Oh, are they lurking on a cure? Is there a telethon? Can I make a donation?
You know that's not what it means. It means I speak for you.
But then why are you arguing with yourself? We're going to do this here song.
All right, Bosworth, what is the song?
It's that old classic Christmas carol, Randolph the Red-Leaked Nagtag.
You mean Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer?
No, sir, no. Randolph the Red-Leaked Nagtag.
Okay, you kids want to hear his song?
Yeah!
Here we go. Y'all know Echo, and Jekyll,
yeah,
and Cluck,
mm-hmm,
and Nina Third.
Yes.
But have you ever heard of the most famous nagtie of all?
No.
Hit it. Randolph the Red Beak Nagtie had a their shiny beak, and if you ever saw it, it would make you go, oh, eek. All of the other nagpies used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Randolph join in any nagpie games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Randolph, with your beak so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the magpies loved him as they shouted out with glee, Randolph the Red-Beaked Magpie, you'll go down in history.
Caw, caw, caw,
caw!
Well, that was fantastic, guys. I think it's time for us to go. Everybody wish the kids at home Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas!
Happy Christmas, everybody! And God bless.
Where does Santa Claus hide his present to Mrs. Claus? The closet, of course.
Let's all get ready to play Jingle Bells. Are y'all ready? All right, let's go.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Oh, that's it, we go. Laughing all the way. Ha, 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 bells on top to ring. Making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
What's a snake's favorite Christmas carol? Sleigh ride.
Oh my gosh, it was so crazy. I was like, what's happening? All of a sudden, there's like this little baby.
Baby Jesus.
Oh my gosh.
He was like so cute.
Oh my gosh, he was so cute. I was like, I'm in love.
I see. Okay, and then what happened after he was born? Can you tell us?
like all of our friends showed up. Oh my gosh. From like the fields, and they had their shepherds with them.
Yeah, like 3 or 4 flocks. It was crazy. I was like, oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh. And they said they saw some like massive choir of angels.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, my friend Mindy, she said it was like the most amazing thing she had ever seen in her entire life.
And I guess they told them to come to our stable and stuff because baby Jesus was born.
Yeah, and he's like such a big deal.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, he's supposed to like change the world or something.
Oh my gosh.
What did one snowman say to the other? Do you smell carrots?
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Wrong way the world and sin in narrow pining, till He appears and the soul.
Praise the Son that He came to earth through a virgin birth, foretold for centuries and decades past. He's the anointed one of God, the Redeemer of the world, who would die, speared through His side and nailed to a cross. Baby Jesus lying in the manger, do you know that you've come to die? Baby Jesus, are you aware? Between smiles and giggles, your sweet cute dimples, you came to us to set us free. Kings bowed before you, your shepherds came to see you. Angels sang to you a welcoming song, prophet long to meet you. The universe to greet you, the righteous one who came to save us all. Baby Jesus lying in the manger, do you know that you come to die? Baby Jesus, are you aware? Between smiles and giggles, your sweet cute dimples, you came to us to teach us how to love. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you. Happy your birthday has made us all. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy your birthday has made us all. Christmas is nearly here, that special time of year, and I hope this Christmas is special to you.
I'm Diva Chica, the church house mouse. I love to read stories inside God's house. They teach us many lessons that we all must know, and they help in many ways our hearts and minds to grow. I'm Diva Chica, the church house mouse. I love to read stories inside God's house. My husband Tico, he lives here with me, and we're each a small part of God's family. I'm Diva Chica, the church house mouse. Diva Chica, the church house mouse. I'm Diva Chica, the church house mouse. Oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging. Oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging. Not only green when summer's here, but also winter's cold and drear. Oh, Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging.
Hi there, boys and girls. Divatika here with another story from Out of This World Bookwormies Book Review. And today, I'm going to read a story called The Christmas Tree, written by my friend Mr. Buddy. Gather around the Christmas tree, the evergreen we decorate, to celebrate the nativity, a symbol of life we await. Many colored balls in shining, beautifying lights of bright, tinsel garland all announcing the sense of merriment tonight. Gather around our Christmas tree, standing straight, rising to a point. Each limb has ornaments to see, and over our souls, peace to anoint. While Yuletide carols we shall sing, twinkling, gleaming, an inciting sight is dancing around the Christmas tree, memories tomorrow full of delight. Gather around the Christmas tree, surrounded by presents of love, there, complete with wings of joy, stands guardian angel above. Hi, moms and dads and kiddos at home. It's me, Divatika here, just wishing you a Merry Christmas.
How do cats greet each other on Christmas?
How?
A furry Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad, prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad, prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.
Who gives presents and bites people?
Who?
Santa Claus.
Ho, 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 ho! And away we go! Whoops! Alfie!
When Santa got stuck up the chimney, he began to shout, "You girls and boys won't get any toys if you don't pull me out. My beard is black, there's soot in my sack, my nose is tickling too." Santa got stuck up the chimney. Achoo! 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 When Santa got stuck up the chimney, he began to yell, "Oh, hurry please, it's time to squeeze, my sack is stuck as well. Hurry, it's cold up here, and Rudolph's nose is blue." When Santa got stuck up the chimney, achoo! Achoo! Achoo!
Signal. Help! We need you to close your eyes and make wish really hard that Santa gets unstuck!
Help us!
From Keys TV.
Shekels! Shekels! Where are you, Shekels? There you are!
That is a Christmas!
There you are! Where have you been, you silly pup?
You will not believe me. You will not believe me. I was in the mall doing some last minute Christmas shopping and I saw Santa Claus! The Santa Claus at the mall! So, I had to hide from him.
Well, why would you have to hide from Santa?
I thought you liked him.
I did like Santa Claus a lot. But, well, I haven't exactly been a good doggy all year, and I thought he would be mad at me.
Oh, well, Shekels, I don't think Santa would be mad at you. In fact, I think he would want you to think about what you've done and tell God you're sorry.
Do you think God would be mad at me for all the bad things I've done? You know, like the time I chewed on the rug, or the time that I bit the mailman, or the time that I chased the neighbor's cat,
Not at all, Shekels. Especially not if you ask God to forgive you. We make mistakes all the time, and it's important to go straight to God and tell him that you're sorry.
I guess I should have done that instead of hiding from Santa. I will make sure I talk to God before I get him. I want to make sure that he knows how really sorry I am.
That's a great idea, Shekels. Oh, the movie's about to start. Let's go!
A lot of things have changed since the day I met Jesus. Things have been completely different around Jerusalem and, well, pretty much around the world. And I've changed too. It's been a little more peaceful in my stable ever since I told my family that I'd given up singing. But that doesn't mean I gave up dancing.
Dear, I think we should cut down on his sugar intake.
You know, I was never this hyper. Even after I carried Jesus.
What? You carried Jesus too? When?
Boy, I'm not talking to you until you take off that ridiculous jewelry.
Dad, it's not jewelry. This is my bling.
I was a young buck when it happened, and in great shape. I'd always wanted to race, but unfortunately, I was just a work donkey. I always wanted to do something big and important, but I belonged to a small family in Nazareth. A man and his wife, and their daughter named Mary. She was about to get married to a man named Joseph, but she was already pregnant when she said that an angel appeared to her and told her that she would give birth to the baby that would save the world. I believed her though. Joseph, the man she was going to marry, he believed her too. And they were about to have that baby when something unexpected happened.
Hear ye. Yeah, everyone needs to return to his hometown to register for a census. Yeah, that's right.
So, what's a census?
That meant that the government was counting how many people were in the country. So everyone had to go back to where their family came from to be counted. So Mary and Joseph had to go to Bethlehem, which was a very long way away.
And they chose you?
Anyway, I was in the best shape, so they picked me for the job. I was excited about where we were going to stay in Bethlehem, but there were no rooms available anyway, so I ended up in a stable again. But we got to the stable just in time, and Mary had her baby. As soon as we saw the baby, we knew that he really was what the angel had told her, the Son of God, and they named him Jesus. Since Jesus was called a king, I thought there would be all kinds of important people around, and we would be staying in some fancy palace. But the Savior of the world was born in a stable, in the box that the animals ate out of, with only his parents and a couple of shepherds there to see him. So I guess God showed me what's really important. Doesn't matter how strong you are, what stuff you have, God can use you. And I got to carry him. And I didn't have to wear any snazzy bling neither.
Each of you has been blessed with one of God's many wonderful gifts to be used in service to others, so use your gift well. 1 Peter 4:10.
What do elves learn at elf school?
What?
The alphabet.
Hey, boys and girls and their parents. This is Shekels, the dog,
I just wanted to wish you a very, very Merry Christmas, full of presents and burns and chew toys and lots of puppy doggies. Have a very Merry Christmas.
What candle burns longer?
What?
None, they all burn shorter.
There's only one of me and you. We're all unique and so are you. Greater than the greatest masterpiece of art. Of a spirit created with a heart. I think God touches every baby girl and boy on the cheeks to say, you make me happy, you give me joy. And every smile, a priceless dimple says to the baby, so sweet and simple. I'm sure baby Jesus smiled up with a dimple. I think God touches every baby girl and boy on the cheeks to say, you make me joy. And every smile a priceless dimple says to the world, cheer is ever near in the Lord, have you heard? Cheer is ever near in the Lord, have you heard?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Hoo-hoo.
Hoo-hoo-hoo.
It's Santa Owl.
Hi kids, I'm Skipper Jay.
And I'm Lovey D.
On behalf of Keys for Kiddos and Keys Media Productions, we would like to thank you for tuning in.
And we would like to wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child.
What do you call Santa's dog?
What?
Santa Paws!
Well, howdy there, kiddos!
Hi, Mr. Phil!
Howdy, Corky!
Howdy, Mr. Thiel! Howdy, kiddos! And a big ol'
yee-haw!
To all those kiddos watching us at home!
And Merry Christmas, everybody!
Merry Christmas!
You know, this is the time that Santa Claus will be coming soon.
Oh! Yeah, sure, I suppose.
Well, what is it, Corky? Don't you believe in Santa Claus?
Oh, no, I believe in Santa Claus, all right. It's my Aunt Nidge. She doesn't believe in Santa Claus.
Oh, that's too bad, Corky.
Yeah. So I got a plan. This year I'm going to prove to her that Santa Claus really does exist.
Oh, how are you? Yeah, how are you going to do that?
What are you going to do, Corky? Well, kids, I'm going to line the chimney with fishing hooks. Going to catch me a whopper.
Well, that ought to do it, Corky. That ought to do it.
Say, you know what? With all this newfangled DNA science, they've got Santa Claus's DNA, and they're going to prove what nationality he is.
Oh, well, what nationality is Santa Claus, Corky?
He's North Polish.
Oh, Corky. Well, you know, it is Christmas time. So how about we recite for everybody that classic Christmas poem?
Oh, yeah, sure. We'll do Peter Cottontail.
No. Peter Cottontail's for Easter, Corky. We need to do something for Christmas.
Well, okay. I do know. 'Twas the night before Christmas.
Uh-huh.
In Texas.
Oh, I've never heard that one. You guys want to hear 'Twas the night before Christmas in Texas?
Yeah!
How about you at home? You want to hear it? Well, that sounds like a yes to me, Corky.
Okay, kids, here we go. 'Twas the night before Christmas in Texas, you know, way out on the prairie, without any snow. Asleep in their cabin, their Duddy and Sue, a dreaming of Christmas, like me and like you. Not stockings, but boots at the foot of their bed, 'cause this is Texas! What more needs to be said? when out of the still of the night there comes such a ruckus, it gives me a fright. I look across the prairie, and like a shot from a gun, a loaded up duck dart to come on at a run. The driver was geeing and hawing with a lil, and the horses, not reindeer, he drove with such skill.
Come on there, Buck, and Poncho, and Prince, to the right! Ho, 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 ho! There'll be plenty of traveling for y'all tonight! Ho, 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 ho!
He was dressed in Levi's, in a shirt that was red, and he wore a 10-gallon Stetson on top of his head. As he stepped off the duckboard, he was really a sight, with his mustache and beard so curly and white. He burst through the cabin, and the children awoke, and were so astonished that neither one spoke. He filled up the boots with such presents galore that neither could think of another thing more. Then, when Duddy recovered the use of his jaws, he asked in a whisper, "Are you really Santa Claus?"
"Ho, ho, 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 ho! Am I the real Santa? Ho, 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 ho! Well, what do you think?"
And he smiled and gave a mysterious wink. Then he hopped on his duck guard and exclaimed in his drawl,
"To all the children of Texas, ho, 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 ho! Merry Christmas, y'all! Ho, 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 ho!"
"Merry Christmas, Sir the Dottie! Merry Christmas, kiddos! Merry Christmas!"
Well, that was just great, Porky. That was just great. What do you guys want to do now?
Let's sing.
Well, what do you want to sing?
Silent Night.
Yeah, Silent Night.
Yeah, that sounds great.
Oh, okay, you want to sing Silent Night.
Okay, let's sing Silent Night. Y'all ready?
Yeah!
Here we go.
Silent night, holy night, all is cold, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child.
Well, that was great, kids. That was great, Corky. Well, I think it's time for us to go for now. So everybody tell everybody watching us at home, Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, Heather Dotty, and yee-haw!
Hey, y'all ready? Y'all ready?
Yes.
Y'all ready?
Merry Christmas!
Hi, everybody. I'm Mr. Phil.
I'm Corky.
I'm Roman.
And I'm Sydney.
The Harmony Key Kids. And we want to invite you all to watch our Christmas episodes of Keys for Kiddos right here on the Keys web channel and the Keys website. Ready? Ready? Merry,
Merry Christmas!
Okay, Spoonhead, are you ready?
Ready for what, Lacey?
To make a recipe, of course. I need your help.
I love making recipes. What are we going to make?
We're going to make something that's yummy to our tummy. It's called Rice Krispie Treats.
Wow, Lacey, I'm already flipping with excitement. What kind of ingredients are we going to need to make them?
Well, first you're going to need 3 tablespoons of butter. Then you're going to need a bag of marshmallows. Next, you're going to need 6 cups of Rice Krispie cereal.
Yummy! What can I do? I want to help!
You can help stir, Spoonhead. We're going to stir the butter. We're going to stir the marshmallows. And then we're going to mix it all together. And the butter and the marshmallows are going to be melted on the stove.
Ooh, sticky!
Then we're going to need to put the Rice Krispie cereal in with the melted ingredients. Today, we're gonna cook, then eat, then share.
What does that mean?
Well, first we're gonna cook, then we're gonna eat, and then we're gonna share with all our friends. What do you think?
It's spoon-tastic!
Good, because the best part's coming. We're going to share it with all our friends.
There's a snap, crackle, and pop!
Ba-da-ba-da. Ba-da-ba-da. Ba-da-ba-da.
Petey wants a cracker! 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 Oh boy! Somebody loves some crackers! Petey wants a cracker! Petey wants a cracker! These don't taste like crackers, but they sure do taste delicious!
Okay, am I straight? Do I look good? My hair, is it okay? Hold that mirror up a little bit. Oh, thank you. Stacy, you did a great job with my makeup. Thank you so much. Okay, I think we are almost ready. I'm all straight, right? You said yes? Okay, good. Lacey, you ready?
Yep.
Okay, here we go.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer.
Reindeer.
Had a very shiny nose.
Like a light bulb.
And if you ever saw it.
Solid.
You would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer.
Reindeer.
Used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph.
Rudolph.
Join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say,
ho, ho, ho,
Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then all the reindeer loved him.
Loved him.
As they shouted out with glee,
yippee!
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer.
Reindeer.
He'll go down in his story.
Like Columbus!
What do you call people who are afraid of Santa Claus? Claustrophobic!
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. While shepherds kept their watching o'er silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
The shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel chorus that held the Savior's birth.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Down in a lowly manger the humble Christ was born, and God sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Hey, Abby, Abby, guess what?
What, Aaron?
The shepherds in the field say that the Messiah Jesus was born tonight, right here in Bethlehem. They're going to worship him right now. Come on, let's go too.
Yeah, I want to go see him. Let's go. Wow, he's so small.
They say he's gonna save the world.
How is he gonna do that?
Well, Dad said that God would send us a savior, and that savior would be the Son of God. And so, I guess since this is God's Son, I guess he'll be the one to save us from our sins.
Wow, he sounds really special. I wish I could do something special for him.
That's a good idea. But we don't have anything to give him. Wait a minute. Abby, why don't you sing him a song?
But there's so many people here. What if I sing badly and baby Jesus starts crying?
I've heard you sing while you're helping Mom with the chores, and I think you have a pretty voice. Besides, your big brother is right here with you.
Okay, I'll sing. But only if you sing with me.
Of course, let's sing together.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay.
I think he liked it.
I think he liked it too.
Thanks for singing with me, Aaron. You're the best big brother ever.
And you're a pretty good sister, too.
Hello! Give me the doctor, please! Hello, doctor! Come quickly! My son is ill! He's got a problem! I don't know what it is, but get here quickly!
Hello, Mrs. Knickerbocker!
Hello.
I'm the doctor. Can I help you?
Hi, Doc! Well, I'll tell you, my son's got a problem.
What seems to be the symptoms?
Well, it all started the other day when I was at the mall with him. And all of the toys started crying, "Buy me, buy me, buy me." The clothes started saying, "Buy me, buy me, buy me." My son wanted them. And I said no, and his eyes turned red. His cheeks turned red. He started jumping up and down. I don't know what to do, Doc. Help me.
It sounds to me like he's got a bad case of the gimmies.
The gimmies? What's the gimminies?
Well, what it is when the kids, they see what they want and they go, "Gimme, gimme, gimme." And the parents just give them, give them, give them. And you know what happens then?
What?
They want more, more, more.
Yeah, that's it. That's what he's got. That's what he's got. What do we do, Doc?
Well, what you're going to do is you're going to give him a bowl of cereal.
A bowl of cereal?
That's right.
What's that going to do?
Well, you fill the bowl and give him the cereal.
But, Doc, he'll spill it all over him. And he'll make a big mess that I have to clean up.
That's the point.
What?
Because what you're going to do is you're going to give him what he needs. A spoon.
A spoon? What will that do?
Well, just like God only gives us what we need in spoonfuls, you're going to give him the cereal in spoonfuls.
Wow, that's a great idea, Doc. But I wonder if it doesn't work. What do I do then?
Well, you use the biggest cure of all.
What's that?
When he says he wants something and you say no, he's gonna ask you why not. And you're gonna say, "Because I said so."
Yay! That's a great idea, Doc. Thank you so much.
And
around the world, they make the world go round. A little girl was lost once told him his mind couldn't find a way at all. Then one candle gave her some light and led her safely home. There's a little candle glowing in the night, helping to give some light. If more little candles showed around the world, they make the world so bright. The family was happy when she came home. They had an awful fright. They thought that they'd never see her again after that cold dark night. There's a little candle glowing in the night, helping
for Christmas.
What?
A snowy sleigh station.
Hey, what are you doing here in Harmony Keys?
I'm on vacation. It's beautiful here.
Shouldn't you be at the North Pole?
No, not me.
But it's hot here. Aren't you going afraid you're going to melt?
Of course not! I'll be fine! Hey, would you join me in a dance?
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Glad tidings to you and your kin. Glad tidings of Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas!
Caw caw caw!
Hey kids, I hope you've enjoyed celebrating the true meaning of Christmas with us today.
Yes, it's fun learning why we celebrate Christmas in the first place. I mean, no matter how great it is to get presents and eat cookies and decorate the Christmas tree, we need to remember that Jesus is the reason for the season.
Exactly, Skipper. But we don't just celebrate Jesus at Christmas time, we celebrate him all through the year because he died on the cross for us so that we can live.
That sounds like the best Christmas present ever.
It is, and you know what? We can give Christ a Christmas gift as well, because all we have to do is to pray for him to come into our hearts, and that will make God so happy, and he'll throw a party for us in heaven.
I love parties.
Can we go ahead and give Jesus a gift right now?
Sure. Let's all sing him a song together.
joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven, heaven and nature sing.
Don't you think it's a pretty good plan? All I want for Christmas is a real good tan. All I want for Christmas is a real good tan. Take me to the islands, put my feet in the sand, rocking to and fro with the rhythm of the ocean, singing silent night with the palm trees a-blowing. Ooh, don't you think it's a pretty good plan? All I want for Christmas is a real good tan.
Merry Christmas!
As Houston's newest provider of faith-based television, Keys TV offers a variety of Christ-centered and inspirational programs. We promise our viewers, sponsors, and supporters to give our community a Christian representation of inspiring, uplifting, dramatic, humorous programs and a sounding platform at an affordable price for the area churches and ministries to reach the churched and unchurched.